Hey, what's up, guys? Been a long time since I made a video. Hope everybody's doing great with this whole COVID situation. Since all this has been going on, and you know, they haven't been able to go to the track, or there hasn't even been any events with this downtime, I'm sure everybody was doing upgrades to the car. One upgrade that I'm doing is a 15-inch conversion to the vert. I did it the cheap way. I didn't do it with the Carlisle kit, or I didn't do it with the SMG kit, which are both great kits. This is kind of using the GM Performance kit, but instead of going through GM Performance or the dealership and paying $700-$800 for it, I pieced all the parts together. And instead of running 16s, I'm doing 15s, just a little grinding stuff like that. So what you got to look for, Cadillac ATS base model, ATS. Mine are from a 2014, I'm pretty sure. I think 2013 and up use the same ones. You might have to verify. But from looking around, looking at different part numbers, they look, mine is a 2014. 2014, so let's go with 2014 and up. Rear brake calipers and rear brake pads. Also, what you're gonna need is you're gonna need new rotors. Now for rotors, what I used was Cadillac CTS base model. So you're looking at the V2 CTS, just base model, no CTS-V, because you know those are big brakes. So you get those will work. Also, fifth gen V6 rotors will work as well. I learned the hard way. I went online, did the forums, did some searching. Some people said the V6 rotors will work. They didn't specify which ones, unfortunately. So, me, I learned the hard way. There's all the rotors that I had to buy. So the ones that I'm using are these guys. I got them from AutoZone. 7238. So those are the ones for the base model CTS-V. CTS-V, the CTS that I'm using. And they seem to work fine. They look like the calipers clear them. And so with the calipers, I'll show you. You got to do some grinding. All right, so here's the caliper after it's all been shaved down. If you look at it, once you get yours, you buy some of these calipers off eBay, wherever you get them. This is kind of showing you how far down you have to grind them. You see they're pretty low. They're not exactly flush, but they're getting close to it. And you also have to come back here and you have to cut down the bleeder screw. You see that? Because if you don't cut that down, trust me, you're gonna be hitting the barrel of the wheel, and you don't want to do that. Left side. But yeah, see it? It took a while to grind it down. Usually I used a bench grinder and just start working my way, trying to get it as smooth as I can. And yeah, I'm just gonna paint them black. So after I did the grinding, got a little paint job right over here as well. Little paint job to them, make them all look good. So again, you're using base model ATS calipers and brackets with brake pads. Mine are from a 2014, and I believe it's 2014 and up. They work all the same. I did this the cheapest way possible. So the brake calipers, I got them off eBay used for $40 for the pair. So that was the best deal I found. Usually they go from 100 to 150 for a used pair, but these popped up for $40, bought them on the spot. So I'm $40 into the calipers. The brake pads were $20 off Rock Auto. They're Friction Master, whichever those are, but they're $20 off Rock Auto. So right there, I'm $60 into just brake calipers and brake pads. The rotors, I ended up taking a bite on because, you know, I was trying to figure out which rotors worked. The V6 six gens didn't work, so I ended up going with the CTS. So the rotors, I ended up spending about $120. So you look at it, I'm 180 into it. The most expensive part you're going to spend money on are the tow rods. Alright, so for the tow rods, you gotta go aftermarket. I got them from BMR, from Summit Racing. The BMR set me back about $240 after Summit's deals that they have. So you got 240, and you got what, 120, 180. So you got 180 plus 240. So you do the math. I'm looking at about $420. So I'm $420 into parts. The last thing you gotta buy is for the back side of the calipers to let the brake line or the brake hose go to these new calipers. You need a guy, you need to get these guys. So these guys, little banjo bolt, already comes with two washers and you just get it O'Reilly's. That's where I got it, right here. And that's pretty much all you need. So I'm $420 into this 15 inch conversion. Of course, that's aside, whatever wheel's gonna go with, you go welds. You can do the cheap versions, which is the Summit Racing or the JX brands, the Vision wheels, which they're like $120 a wheel. That's the cheap, that's probably the cheapest you can go with, or whatever you want to go with. With me, I went with Race Stars. I already had polished Race Stars, so I just sold my 17s and I'm going with a 15 inch. And then once I got all this put together, I'll show you guys, I'll show you which one I'm running. I'm running the 15 by 10 plus 42. All right, so that's like a 7.2 backspacing on there, and it seemed to work fine. Now, when you do all this, another thing you have to do for the BMR tow rods, they're gonna be sticking out a little too far past the dust shield on that. And I'll show you what I'm talking about. This guy right here. So what you end up doing is you have to get rid of the stock bolt and get a button head bolt. And then once you get a button head bolt, you also got to trim. This guy, you gotta trim the little, this little spacer for the BMR tow rod. And I'll show you what I'm talking about right now. So, right there, that's the stock spacer still on the new rod. So I'll show you a little bit of how much it went off. So that's, if you look at it, what I did was get rid of this little lip right here. At work, we have a lathe, so I used the lathe and just shaved it down right to that edge right there on both sides. So on this side right here and on that side, for the one that's by the knuckle, you got to shave it down to that. And also these guys, got to make sure, here's a stock one next to the aftermarket, and you got to shave them down as well. I grinded them down and chased the threads, and it seems to work fine. So all in all, there's a little bit of work that these aftermarket guys are doing for you, which if you don't feel like doing work, you want something to bolt on, they're great ways to go. GM Performance, SMG kit, and the Carlisle. Me, I'm trying to do the cheapest way possible for this upgrade, so this is how I went about it. Bear with me. You know, I'm gonna do a little run through of the install, and at the end I'll show you the finished product, how the 15s work. Go looking good. As you can see, it's on there. I'm gonna put the ring inside there so it can be centered, but you can see it's pretty nice and it's moving nice and freely. But that's it, guys. If you have any questions, feel free to DM me on Instagram, Facebook, whichever. Slow.vert is the tag on Instagram and on Facebook as well. Like, share, subscribe. I'm going to be doing a couple more things to the car before it's ready to race. So yeah, thanks for watching.